one of the things that we have been working on for many years is studying really how insects fight infection. And we focus on mosquitoes because they transmit disease. They're these pesky insects that bite you. They're really the worst of the worst of the insects. One of the things that we had noticed is that when a mosquito fights infection, it's not just their immune system that fights infection, but that its immune system works together with its circulatory system to combat whichever microbes come into the body. One of the things that we were trying to figure out here is whether this thing that we just happened to see in mosquitoes, whether it extends to insects in general, and whether it's a rule that is specific to this small group of bad insects, or whether it's a rule that applies throughout the insect tree of life. One of the things that we did is we came out a little bit out of our comfort zone, and we decided to collect insects in the wild and bring them into the lab. We got a permit from the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation. And with that permit, we got permission to go into state parks and collect local insects here in Tennessee. Within the insects, you have both good insects and bad insects. You have the good insects that are pollinators that allow us to have our food supply. You have the bad insects that destroy crops and also transmit disease. All the insects, regardless of whether they're good or bad, they are susceptible to infection. Learning how insects fight infection might allow us to figure out ways to help those beneficial insects overcome their infection so they can still pollinate, make honey, or anything else that they might be making. But also, learning how they fight infection might help us combat these agricultural pests or these insects that transmit disease. This project was really interesting in terms of the findings that we had. What we found is that this observation that we had in mosquitoes really applies across the insect tree of life. This kind of research helps us understand better how insects work in general.